One, two, three,
Fall. See, Bruce Fowler has just completed a genuine bebop-influenced tango trombone solo. But that's not all he can do because, well, how shall I say this? He's so far out, ladies and gentlemen. He's been to college and everything, and because of this, he is an expert in the graceful art of bebop tango dancing. Now, he has developed a special dance routine, which he will perform for you with the assistance of Napoleon. They're going to work this out. Easy, Bruce. Easy, big fella. Okay. This is a special bebop dance that they've planned just for you. Give them your undivided attention. Take it away. Well, it certainly sounds like bebop, you know. Don't let them stop you, George. Keep telling them about the bebop.
That's right, hon.
George. Do you understand that you're in Canada now? You realize that, don't you? You realize that if you continue to sing bebop in that manner to a Canadian audience, that you might not get any pussy tonight? Do you realize that it is within the realm of possibility that bebop itself as a concept is too evolved for the Canadian audience? Because from where I stand, I see that this audience is extremely reserved. I know that you must be under a great deal of pressure in an institution of higher learning. We've experimented with bebop in such advanced places as Paterson, New Jersey, Detroit, Michigan, Waterbury, Connecticut, and now at last, the bebop tango has come to Waterloo, wherever it is. Just to give you a brief idea of what took place at these other areas, we selected a likely suspect from the audience, somebody who appeared to be evolved to the point where they could actually take part in our bebop tango contest. And what we did is we had the spotlight man rove it through the audience and just pull it across these people and see if there's anybody who appears to be ready, willing, and able to participate in the bebop dance. I mean, I hate to ask for volunteers, but is that a volunteer or is that a volunteer? Hey, you are a volunteer. How about a succulent young lady to assist him in the bebop tango routine? Is there one woman among you who is evolved enough to dance with? Hey, a second volunteer. Hey. All right, ladies and gentlemen, be real quiet. I want to find out what their names are. What is your name, sir? All I can hear three things. I hear Don, it's either Marginal, Marshmallow, or Markenum. What is it? Marginal? Hey. No, he's got to do it right there where you can really see him and experience his aura. And young lady, what is your name? Linda? Domin? Norman? Dormer? What can I say? Oh, wait, no, you don't do it sitting down. You have to do, that's it. Have a little beer, honey. Okay, Linda and Don, was that it? Don, John. It's John and Linda, ladies and gentlemen. All right, now here's the deal, John and or Linda. Or in tandem, or any combinations thereof which appeal to your fancy. Now, George is going to sing a genuine bebop vocal lick, and all you have to do is move your body systematically to the rhythm that he will project to you. You communicate, you link your mind with his mind, you link your body with his notes. The rhythmic figures will overcome you. You are going to sleep. You are going to sleep. Okay, now here's a quick sample. George is going to give you a little number like this. I'll show you how to dance to it. You ready? Try it one time. Get the picture? It's a sort of a spastic, sort of a weird, sort of a twisted, sort of a perverted, sort of obsessed, sort of twitching, sort of bebop, sort of tango dance that you can do. Everybody, get the picture. Here we go. George, make them dance. Oh, no, you're too reserved. You're too reserved. You have to let yourself go. Do you understand? Wait, follow me one time. Make me dance, George. Now, just, I don't know how to get this across to you, but you have to loosen yourself up. You have to let yourself go. Just forget you're in Canada just for a moment, okay? You ready? Okay. Start them off easy with a little groove. Okay. Now, come on, twitch. No, no, look, here's where you're making your mistake. You're trying to stay on the beat like this. Don't listen to that beat over there. Listen to the one that goes... and dance to that one. Anybody can go like that, okay? Show these people where you're coming from. I still think you're too reserved. You think that, is it possible that you could all stand up for a minute and just twitch around to this? It couldn't hurt you. Okay. All right, sweep the audience with the spotlights. Make it look like there's something really going on in this gymnasium. This is the world's championship bebop twitch-a-thon. And I want to see every single one of you highly evolved Canadians out there twitching your brains out. Twitch, George, give it to him, George. But you're just standing there. Are you tired? Oh, well. Sit down. It's okay. Just sit down and calm yourselves, really. No, no. Really. It's okay. Really. It's all right. Just, it's all right. Really. I mean, sit down. I mean, please, ladies and gentlemen, please just sit down. You'll be able to see better, and they'll be able to see better. Just sit down. I'll tell you, there is no way in the world that you people are going to be able to dance to bebop. It's just too hard for you. I never thought we'd meet with failure in Canada, but I guess this is it, folks. Your vibes and your aura have projected themselves into a realm of complete relaxation. That person with his arm up in the air, that person up there in the top knows what I'm talking about. That person up there at the top. Give that man a chance to bebop one more time. That guy, twitch it. That's it. Now don't fall down. Just sit back. This was not meant to injure anyone, okay? Now, as the next step in our bebop educational process, we want to expose you to the potential delights of the marimba as an instrument of bebop expression when applied to the tango, as imported to Canada. Ladies and gentlemen, Ruth Underwood will now play the delicate, sensitive, bebop teardrop marimba solo. Take it away, Ruth. Make them weep. Thank you. top event must eventually resolve itself to that basic driving force, which is at the very core of bebop itself. And you know what I'm talking about, ladies and gentlemen, the rhythm section. What rhythm section would be complete without a bebop bass solo? Take it away, Tom. Give me a little bebop. Bebop licks tend to sound the same after a while, but there's one thing that will endure, and that is the bebop, highly evolved drum solo competition between Ralph Humphrey, who is contestant number one, and Chester Thompson, who is contestant number two, and eventually even including Ruth Underwood, who will be contestant number three. And judged by you, who will or will not be the audience, as the case may be. Take it away, Ralph. Hit it. Number, there is a percussion event they can all play together, ladies and gentlemen. Tap your toes to the lilting strains of Tamershi Duween.
Wait a minute.
What do you mean, wait a minute? Ladies and gentlemen, Ruth is going to miss 25% of her cues tonight. Keep your eye on Ruth. The red jerkin is significant. Are you ready? Oh, she's not ready. Ladies and gentlemen, just vamp until she comes in. And take it away. Will miss 5% of his cues tonight, ladies and gentlemen. gross and perverted. I'm obsessed and deranged. I have existed for years, but very little has changed. I'm the tool of the government and the industry too, for I am destined to rule and regulate you. I may be vile and pernicious, but you can't look away. I'll make you think I'm delicious with the stuff that I say. I am the best you can get. Have you guessed me yet? I am the slime oozing out from your TV set. You will obey me while I lead you and eat the garbage that I feed you. Until the day that we don't need you, don't go for help, no one will heed you. Your mind is totally controlled. It has been stuffed into my mold. And you will do as you are told until the rights that you are told. That's right, folks, don't touch that dial.
I am the slime from the video, featuring the long hearted Liverpool floor. I am the slime from the video, and I'm the slime from the video. I am the slime from the video, moving the long hearted Liverpool floor. I am the slime from the video, can't stop the slime, people look at me.
Thank you. All right, we're now going to play a collection of three songs for you. The first and the last one are new, and the middle one is old. First one is called Pygmy Twilight. The second one is called The Idiot Bastard Son. And the third one is called A Little More Cheapness, Please.
Testing one.
Bye.
in Congress today. The mother's a hooker somewhere in L.A. Feed in the jar. In this area, called Funobulax, has just been seen approaching the power plant. Bullets can't stop it. Rockets can't stop it. Grenades can't stop it. We may have to use nuclear force. Everyone is advised to go to the gymnasium at once.
Please. Baby, I'm shy, cause that's all I wanna do. Need a little more cheapest, please. Baby, I'm shy, cause that's all I wanna do. Need a little more cheapest, cheaper than that. Baby, I'm shy, cause that's all I wanna do. Need a little more cheapest. Baby, I'm shy, cause that's all I wanna do. Need a little more cheapest, cheaper than that. Baby, I'm shy, cause that's all I wanna do. Need a little more cheapest, cheaper than that.
Thank you. Montana now, and then at the end of Montana, it goes into a song that you probably haven't heard before. It's The Legend of Dupree's Paradise.
Okay. You could.
Ladies and gentlemen, keep your eye on Ruth because she's just not ready. Floss, raising it up, waxing it down in a little white box that I can fill up now. By myself, I would have no boss, but I'd be raising my lonely dental. Throw me some peas, but I'd leave the sweet stuff to somebody else. Ah, but then on the other hand, I would keep the wax and melt it down, pluck the floss and swish it around, and I'd have me a crop, and it'd be all time. That's why I'm moving to Montana.
Moving to Montana soon. Gonna be a dental floss tycoon.
Yes, I am.
Moving to Montana soon. Gonna be a dental floss tycoon.
couch and the blanket on anyway. Find me a horse just about this big and ride him all along the borderline with a pair of heavy duty zircon encrusted tweezers in my hand. Every other wrangler would say I was mighty grand, but by myself I would have no boss, 'cause I'd be raising my lonely little my tweezers gleaming in the moonlight night. A little tweezer glint, and then I get a cup of coffee and give my foot a push. Just me and the pygmy pony over by the dental floss bush. And then I might just look back down and ride like a cowboy into the dawn. Come on, Tana. Thank you.
What you're hearing coming from the synthesizer is the result of a circuit called the sample and hold circuit, which randomly samples white noise and then activates some oscillators and opens and closes a filter on it automatically, allowing George to walk over and pretend to be playing his solo while he was in another place at the same time. We're going to apply the same scientific principle of sort of automatic solo playing during this number. Now, we've never tried this before, but let's think about it for a moment, ladies and gentlemen. When you play a solo in a song, why should it merely be notes? Why should your solo not consist of physical action, spoken words, or any random sort of activity that you would like to include in the expressive part of your endeavor? So, as we continue with this number, ladies and gents, as you play your solos, make sure you include at least 3 random non-musical elements in what you do in this tune, and may the Lord have mercy on your soul.
Oh.